What? I'm not sick.
Well, I certainly had this coming. Dear Mojang, hi, it's me, Austin, blah, 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 I'm sick, and this is the most enthusiasm I can muster right now, because my sinuses have swollen to the size of grapefruits. Hopefully soon, the drugs will kick in, and I can start shouting through the pain like I did when I got my wisdom teeth taken out, and I had to try and record a show hopped up on opioids.
I was gonna do an episode about Far Cry 5 today, but I honestly don't have the energy or interest to invest in a new IP this week, so I'm gonna be going back to my old favorite Minecraft. I don't know what it is, something about the flowing pastoral fields or the horses or the f***ing monsters that show up to destroy everything you've poured your life into. But I find the game comforting when I'm not feeling 100%. Granted, I'd probably find the game a lot less relaxing if I played the game like Mumbo Jumbo does with his massive and extraordinarily terrifying redstone machines, or if I were building functioning Atari emulators that run at one frame per 60 years like Seth Bling. For me, Minecraft is basically a farming simulator, emulating a simple life that I will never have, occasionally punctuated by the destruction of my carefully plotted worlds by some unfeeling, uncaring monstrosity. You know, maybe Minecraft has more in common with Far Cry than I originally thought. Crafting, indiscriminate murder, an antagonist that's a strange amalgamation of various heads of different cults of personality, but in any case, I'm sick, tired, and y'all are always badgering me to get on with the bloody episode already, so here we go! I'm gonna answer this seemingly unanswerable question that nobody asked. How many diamonds are in Minecraft? I don't mean how many are there in a single game, and I don't mean how many you can mine yourself. I mean precisely, exactly how many diamonds are there in the code of Minecraft itself. In every single possible game that could exist in our universe, if you dug them all out, how many would you have? Because believe it or not, there is an answer, and the answer is, well, it's not terrifying per se, but it might be quite literally mind-blowing, and the journey to finding the answer is freaking amazing. But first, before we answer it, we're gonna have to take a look at precisely how Minecraft creates its worlds. Well, I guess technically we don't have to, but it is pretty fascinating, and honestly, the fact of the matter is that while it seems like there's an infinite number of Minecraft worlds, since they're all created seemingly randomly, this is technically not true. There's a distinctly limited number of Minecraft worlds because they're all built the same way, through math. You see, all apparent randomness in computers isn't truly random, it's mathematical. This is because, well, computers all operate according to extremely rigid rules. At the end of the day, everything a computer does boils down to a series of ones and zeros, ons and offs on a multitude of switches down at your processor, like mine, which at its peak can process 19.8 billion ones or zeros every second, which can get incredibly complex, but by definition, it cannot be random. Otherwise, my entire computer would probably crap its pants. That's the technical explanation. A system that follows strict rules, by definition, cannot be random. In fact, it can be argued on a philosophical level that true randomness doesn't actually exist, since our universe itself follows a strict set of rules, but the sheer complexity of the system makes outcomes unpredictable. As a computer scientist and philosopher I'm a huge fan of, Ray Kurzweil said, "The distinction between predictable and determined is an important one." And this is the basic concept upon which computer-based randomness works, or what's called pseudo-randomness. A computer algorithm that's meant to simulate randomness follows strict rules as everything else does, but for all intents and purposes, provides apparently random results. The specifics aren't super important, but the way computers do this is they take what's called a seed, which is a number that determines the starting conditions of the randomness, and then uses that as a launching off point for all of its math. A simple way to visualize it is these three rows, where if row one is on, row two is off, and if row two is off, row three is on. The seed would determine whether the starting state of row one is on or off and work from there. This is a vast oversimplification of how pseudo-randomness works, but it's enough to illustrate that randomness in computers follows these simple rules. And this is how Minecraft builds worlds. Kinda. You can see this for yourself if you go to create a new world and select the customization options. There's even an option to put a seed of your own choosing, and you'll notice if you put the same seed, you'll get the exact same world every single time, down to the placement of the frickin' flowers. This perfectly illustrates how something that's seemingly random is, in fact, not. It just follows a crap ton of complex rules. In fact, Minecraft is even less random than that. It uses a function called purlin noise instead of true randomness. Purlin noise, or its cousin simplex noise, are heavily used in video games for procedural generation, since these algorithms are capable of using the number that came before it to determine the next result, which lets you create more natural looking patterns. Hilariously, purlin noise was developed by mathematician and computer scientist Ken Perlin for all things the movie Tron, to make use of limited resources in computer animation for the most gain. It's hard to see the influence in the movie, but the master control program's texture here is almost assuredly created using purlin noise. So knowing this, and knowing that all the worlds are created within specific rules, we can presume that however many seeds there are will dictate how many unique worlds there are. And thankfully, someone already did this math for us. There's 2 to the 64th power different seeds that can be used to create Minecraft worlds using purlin noise functions, which means there's over 18 trillion possible Minecraft worlds. So, knowing this, all we have to do is figure out the spawn rules for diamonds, and we can get pretty damn close to finding out exactly how many diamonds there are in... Oh, crap.
Crap!
Fuck! I forgot the custom rules! You see, purlin noise operates differently from straight-up randomness by using what's known as octaves. A simple way of thinking of it is in a graph form. Say, over 100 seconds, we'll pick values between 1 and 100 every 10 seconds. Then we'll pick values every 5 seconds, but instead of picking random numbers between 1 and 100, we'll pick between 0 and 50, and add those values to the first graph. Then we'll do it again every second, but this time only pick values between 0 and 25, and add those values to the graph. Each of these recursive stages is what's known as an octave, and it's the key behind how purlin noise works to produce natural-looking randomness. In this way, you get natural-looking macro curves with slight variations that smoothly transition between one number and the next, and if you've played a lot of Minecraft, you can totally see purlin noise all over the place in this game. It's how the algorithm places biomes, for instance, since it works pretty hard to avoid putting, say, a desert right next to a frozen biome, but it's also how the game places everything, from ores to trees. And remember, while everything is placed unpredictably, the placements are still predetermined, because everything has thresholds and are placed mathematically according to these octaves. Diamonds, for instance, have very small thresholds compared to, say, dirt, but they're still placed according to these rules. Every single block has its own purlin noise functions in how it's placed, and they're calculated by chunk. A chunk in Minecraft is 16 blocks by 16 blocks wide from floor to ceiling, containing exactly 65,536 blocks all together. And the unfortunate reality is, while there are 2 to the 64th power seeds that dictate the starting conditions for each Minecraft world, those dictate only the initial starting conditions of all the Perlin noise functions. They do not encapsulate every single possible Minecraft world. Veterans will know that there's different world types. Super flats that are good for experimenting with different construction types. Amplified, where everything is out of freaking control. And large biomes, my personal favorite, where biomes are 4 times larger than they are normally. Which means we're looking at a number far, far larger than 18 trillion when it comes to the number of worlds. But how much larger? You may think it's 4 times larger, but that's because you're wrong! Because while you're thinking along the right track, you've quite possibly forgotten that you can tweak every single Perlin noise function manually in the custom settings. Sea level, caves, strongholds, villages, mineshafts, temples, ocean monuments, dungeons, and whether or not there are lakes and how rare they are, whether or not there are lava lakes and how rare they are, whether or not there are freaking lava oceans, which biomes can spawn, how large the biomes are, what river sizes are, the spawn size of all 11 ores, the number of spawn tries per ore, and the minimum height of each ore vein, and the maximum height of each ore vein, which is all calculated per chunk. Oh, sweet! The Sudafed is kicking in, which is perfect timing because it's time for the advanced settings, each of which can be tweaked to over a billion different settings. The main noise scale, XYZ, depth noise scale, XYZ, depth noise exponent, depth base size, coordinate scale, height stretch, upper limit scale, lower limit scale, biome depth weight, biome depth offset, biome scale width, and biome scale offset. All of these options together mean that for each of the 18 trillion seeds, there's over 1.8 times 10 to the 177th power, which is, hold on, 18 followed by 176 zeros. That is not a real number. That's how many different world options there are per seed, which means when you take that and multiply it by 18 trillion, you get 3.33377 times 10 to the 196th power number of total possible Minecraft worlds without any mods made to the base game. Holy crap, that is functionally infinite, but it is a hard limit. And believe it or not, using this number, we can figure out exactly how many diamonds are in all of these worlds, and it's actually quite simple. Given that diamond ores can be tweaked per world to become as common as, well, veins of dirt, or to be so rare as they don't exist, and we're calculating everything in between, this means that we don't have to individually count each diamond in each different world, which, you know, thank God, because I do not have a simple way of quantifying how long that would even take. All of the ore placements in Minecraft are calculated per chunk, and since diamond spawn rates, like everything else, can be tweaked, Perlin noise actually becomes irrelevant, as we can now start working with straight-up randomness and averages. We just have to figure out, on average, across all these worlds, how many diamond blocks would spawn per chunk, and then multiply that by how many chunks there are, and since we know how many worlds there are, and most importantly, the size limit of those worlds, which is 60 million blocks squared, or 3.6 quadrillion blocks, which amounts to 921.6 quadrillion total blocks per world, which we then multiply by this huge number, which represents the total number of possible Minecraft worlds, which gives us the total number of blocks in all the possible worlds. Divide that by 65,536, the number of blocks per chunk, which finally gives us the total number of chunks, excluding the nether in the end. Multiply that number by the average number of diamond spawn per chunk, which we can get by finding the average number of diamond veins, which can range from 0 to 40, giving us an average of 20, and then we multiply that by the average of diamond spawn per vein, which is between 1 and 50, which is an average of 25.5, which when multiplied together gives us an average number of diamonds that will be spawned per chunk across all the chunks in all the different Minecraft worlds, which is 510. Now we just multiply that number by the total number of chunks in all the Minecraft worlds, which gives us at last the total number of Minecraft diamonds which can be mined in the entire universe, which is 2.39094 times 10 to the 212th power, which is 2.39 times 10 to the 203rd power cubic kilometers of diamonds, which would take up a space of 2.8233 times 10 to the 164th power of cubic light years of space, which, like I said, is an absurdly high number. It's several bajillion times larger than the largest estimated size of the universe. There's no number I can use to make this sound understandable. If you took all the quarks and electrons in our universe and used each one of those to count the total number of universes it would take to contain the number of diamonds in Minecraft, it would take 68 decillion universes worth of quarks and electrons just to reach that number, which I'm pretty sure is not any less confusing, but it's as simple as I can make it. So, what's the point in all this? Just to figure out some large numbers that are impossible to visualize? Well, I guess, maybe. But if I wanted to do that, I'd just go for breaking MatPat's MarioPlex record by calculating how many different placements of blocks are possible in all these various Minecraft worlds, which, you know, I did. It's this number, 10 to the 10 to the 215th power, which is 10 to the power of a 1 followed by 215 zeros, which I can show you. I wanted to show you the entire number, but 10 to the power of 10 to the power of 215 can't actually be displayed on anything since it outnumbers the atoms in the universe by a fair amount. And I'm gonna call it a Minecraftplex because why the hell not? But for me, personally, tearing apart the numbers and math of Minecraft gave me a new appreciation for the game. For one, the craftsmanship that's gone into tweaking the numbers so that they can reliably make interesting and consistently unique worlds that are fun to play in, that's freaking impressive. It also makes it even more impressive that in spite of the mind-blowing complexity of these interwoven systems, the developers have still pretty consistently introduced new elements to play around with, without the entire thing unraveling at the seams. But I think, most importantly, it's made me feel a hell of a lot less guilty for treating the game as a farming simulator. I enjoy the break from complexity and the demands of difficult styles of play. I enjoy the fantasy of a simple pastoral life. And ultimately, making this episode has reinforced the understanding in my mind that there is no wrong way to play Minecraft. We're all just playing out 1 in 10 to the power of 1 followed by 215 zeros of iterations of play, all of which are valid. And honestly, I think that's pretty cool. Sincerely, Austin.